Good morning, this is Stephen Whiteside with your daily market outlook for Wednesday, June 25th, 2008. Looking at the pre-market this morning, we've got futures up across the board, so we are looking for some buying at the open at 9:30 on Wednesday morning. Now, today is a big day in the markets. We've got energy inventories coming out this morning, and we've got the Fed meetings minutes coming out this afternoon. So I don't expect a lot to happen until those two events take place. Now, crude oil and gold are down ever so slightly in the pre-market this morning, so we might see some weakness in the TSX. Let's start out today by looking at some daily charts, reviewing where we are. We're still projecting lower prices for the S&P 500 right now. We found ourselves right on support, closing right on support on Tuesday. A breakdown of that support level would take us back down to 1281. And looking to the upside, we need a daily close above 1352 on a daily basis to get us out of this current downtrend. Looking at the Dow came down and found support at the March lows, so we'd look for a lot lower prices if we started to break down below those March lows. Right now, we need to see a daily close above 12,200 to get us out of this current downtrend. And looking at the NASDAQ was able to come down and fill that open gap, the first open gap. Remember, there's three. We filled the first open gap, and so we're holding support at that point. We are projecting lower prices still for the NASDAQ, so if we were to break down below that open gap, our next target to the downside would be down at 2265. And looking up right now, we would need to see a daily close above 2452 to give us a new buy signal for the NASDAQ. Looking at the TSX, the Canadian markets finally broke out of that range that started back in early May. We did close below 14,500 on Tuesday, so that gives us a new midterm sell signal. If we were able to end the week down at this area, that would also give us a weekly sell signal. There's still lots of time for us to make back some of those losses, but I'm still projecting lower prices. Our panic zone chart had started to move lower, so we're down looking at 13,800 as our first target to the downside for the TSX. Yesterday, we saw some continued weakness in energy stocks, including the energy trusts, and of course, financial stocks moved lower again on Tuesday. Gold stocks were fairly flat yesterday. They basically moved sideways. Uranium stocks had a nice pop, and we now have buy signals in Denison. Paladin popped last week, and it had a nice day yesterday. And Uranium One also saw a buy signal on Tuesday. Fertilizer stocks started to roll over. All we've got so far is some early warning signals for potash. If potash was to close Wednesday below 225, that would give us a new sell signal for potash. Looking at the 60-minute charts for Wednesday, we need to see the TSX above 14,640 to give us a new intraday buy signal on Wednesday. Looking at the S&P 500, it's still on an hourly buy signal from midday on Tuesday. And looking at the NASDAQ, we would need to see an hourly close above 2392 on Wednesday to give us a new intraday buy signal. Okay, that's all for Wednesday. Remember, it's Fed Day, it's Energy Day. Look for a lot of volatility after those announcements come out, but before that, it should be fairly quiet. Have a great day, and we'll talk to you again on Thursday morning.